Hello class, welcome back to Mrs. Cadis's Extremely Low Budget Math Help. So we've been working the last few days on equivalent fractions, and we've talked a lot about the fact that the word equivalent has the word equal in it. So we're looking for fractions that are equal to one another. So I'm going to go through this first example that they gave us, and then we'll do the first one together as well. So if we look here at the example, it has on it two number lines, and they've written in the first fraction that they want us to consider 2/8. And we've talked a lot about the fact that when we're working with fractions on a number line or with shapes, we want to first figure out what that denominator is. And the denominator is determined by the number of parts that your whole is broken into. So on this number line between 0 and 1, if I went down and counted each of those parts, I would find that I would have 8. And then they want us now to go to 2/8. So if I count from 0, 1/8, 2/8, that lands me right here at this point. Now, on my second number line, I can see that this line lines up perfectly with that 2/8. To figure out what the fraction is over here for the answer, I first am going to start by identifying that denominator. I'm going to count the number of parts between 0 and 1 that this is divided equally into. 1, 2, 3, 4 parts. So they put a 4 down on the bottom. And the 1 comes because it is the first section, the first 1/4 on this number line. So 2/8 is equivalent to 1/4. Okay, let's try the next one together. So they've given us again two number lines, and they told us that they want us to look at the 4/8 on that first number line. Again, they got the 8 in the denominator because they counted the number of pieces that is broken into between 0 and 1, and they want us to jump 1/8, 2/8, 3/8, 4/8. So you want to mark what that first number is, that first fraction rather, is, so that you know what you're trying to find an equivalent fraction to. So if I look down, I see that this line matches up perfectly. So looking at now at the second number line, I first want to figure out what is my denominator going to be. So I count my parts. 1, 2, 3, 4 parts in that one whole. So I'm going to put a 4 down in the denominator. To figure out the numerator of my fraction, I'm going to count over 1/4, 2/4. That's where it matches up. So 4/8 is equal to 2/4. I hope that helps you guys tonight. Good luck and have fun.